Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Cligibles Nation. My name is Secret Agent Nixon Cligibles. I'm the founder and the director of the Cligibles Industry Spy Network and the Cligibles Nation. As you can see here, I have a virtual machine of Linux Mint 21 set up. For the next three videos, I will be teaching you how to install an Ubuntu-based, Arch-based, and Fedora-based distribution in order to optimize it for gaming. That said, the first one, we're going to be doing the Ubuntu-based system. That will be Linux Mint, which is the first operating system of the three. I will be doing Mint, then Fedora, then Arch. So we will be loading up here the Mint install manager. I'm using Linux Mint 21 because I already have that available. And we'll continue. We'll test the keyboard out. This does seem to be the correct keyboard, so we will continue with that. Next step, we will need to install multimedia codecs. For you gamers out there, this will be required. And then we'll continue. Prepare the Ubuntu drivers and whatnot. Then we will erase the disk and install Linux Mint. You can also make it to where you want to do a sort of dual partition or dual boot. But if you want to get out of Windows permanently, this is a good chance to go about that. And you'll see I'm in the Los Angeles time zone, which is correct. And now I will type in the name, the computer's name. Will just be doig-qemu. Of course, we'll just do doig on my end. And then I'm going to create a strong and complicated password. If I can actually do this right. Apparently it didn't want to. Anyway, we shall continue and install the operating system. Once the operating system is installed, I'll be right back with you to help you out with some more steps. So now that Mint is installed on the machine, you'll need to reset your machine and you'll be at this screen. This is your login screen where you will enter your strong and complicated password, hit enter, then you'll get yourself into your desktop environment. We are not in need of this right now, but it will show the first steps for what you'll be able to do. But right now, that's not needed. I will head into the settings real quick just to make things a bit faster. Go into effects, desktop and Windows effects, turn that switch off. This will make it way faster and will save you a lot of time. Also, you have this thing here in which a lot of updates would be made. But with that, I'm going to head here, go to preferences, turn this stuff off, make sure that update manager is not needed. So I will quit that for the time being. This is just my personal things here before I do the update. That will be done here shortly. Now, the next step to do will be very simple. I will head into a terminal. And the terminal command, the type will be sudo apt. That's your advanced packaging tool, which is your Ubuntu package manager, because this is Ubuntu based. Then we'll do update. And then you'll do a double ampersand, which means go into sudo apt dist upgrade. You can also use upgrade if you want. I just use dist upgrade for different reasons. The purpose of dist upgrade is on the bottom of your screen now. We'll also do a dash y, which means say yes to this regardless. This process is going to take a little bit of time, so I will be right back with you once these updates are made. Now that the machine is updated, I'll be back to the login screen, enter my strong and complicated password, hit enter, and then I'll go back. There are a couple of things I am going to need to do here. First off, I want to make this look good for you guys. So I am going to, if I can actually do this right, go into, there's no, okay, that's interesting. We'll just do 1920 by 1080. Set it like that. Okay, that looks fine. Keep the new configuration. Turn off the fractional scaling and the screen rotation. So that should be okay. Now you'll be able to see Mint in its glory. We will do another one of these again. Almost put in my actual password there. And there's really nothing to update except these here. These packages were kept back for some reason, but who cares about that? Anyway, I will head into Firefox. And I do not give one rip about it. I don't give a rip-a-renu. First things first, I'm going to be getting the ArkanFox user.js for Firefox here. I will be right back with you in just a second. Now that the user.js file is reloaded, or at least I hope it is, I will head to christitus.com. And the article we're going to want to find, the Ultimate Linux Gaming Guide. This is the one we want. The URL for all the sources that will be used will be in the description below. Now, first things first, let's set that... Anyway, for the video drivers, we'll want to add the architecture here. Control, Shift, and V in our terminal to add the i386 structure. Enter our strong and complicated password. So that means i386 will be added. Now, I want to make sure I'll head to the driver manager. And since this is a virtual machine, I may not need extra hardware drivers. But for the proprietary driver install, if you're on NVIDIA, you will not want to use this. Instead, just use the driver manager that comes with Mint. And for the Mesa driver install, if you're on AMD, then you may want to use this. I'm not entirely sure though. But that said, we'll go into the kernel. I use the standard kernel because XanMod does not work for me. But if it works for you, then you should be fine with the whole install of Licorix or XanMod. I'll probably try Licorix after this. You can also do mainline, but I'm not going to use mainline. If you're on AMD, you'll want to consider this ACO. And then comes WineHQ. This one is going to be a little strange. I'll just go into WineHQ here. To install the latest Wine, you will want the staging version. We will go for the Ubuntu package for 22.04, which is Jammy, because it is Ubuntu 22.04 based. Unless you use Ubuntu 22.10 Kinetic. But that said, we will add the repository. So that part done. And then do the wget, the WineHQ key, right there. Next, we're going to wget the sources and add that to the list there. That part's done. Sudo apt update as per the usual. Now we should have WineHQ. Now the one that I would recommend is the staging branch. That's what I use for gaming on Linux. So you'll do sudo apt install dash dash install recommends WineHQ staging. So now we'll do all of this. You will want to say yes to all of it. Now this will install WineHQ. This is also going to take a little bit of time. While that's going on, you'll also want to grab Lutris as well. But you may want to get, I don't know if you'll want an older version of Lutris or whatnot. But that said, there are a few things to consider here. Now, this webpage is obviously for Ubuntu 20.04 based distributions, but I'm doing Ubuntu 22.04. While that's going on, we can't bring up multiple terminals, so I'm going to bring up another terminal and then do the command ulimit dash capital H lowercase n. It returns 1,048,576 on Mint. That means async is enabled by default, so nothing to worry about there. The next step will require these dependencies here for something called game mode. It's made by Feral Interactive. It's essentially making optimizations for the host machine to make performance a little better and to make the CPU not throttle, if there is throttling done at all. But I have to wait until all of this gets installed, which will take a little bit of time. Now that Wine is installed, we shall also download the dependencies for game mode here. I'll hit Control C, and I'll need to add in sudo because there is no sudo in this command. Enter the password, and then this will grab many of the different packages. This also seems to include Git as well, but I will also install Git just in case. So Git is already installed. Fantastic. Next step, and I will keep the window open on top. I guess the next idea will be to do sudo apt install game mode. You could do that as well, which I think I'll have to do it this way. I don't know why I am putting in the password I usually use. And game mode is already built to the latest version 1.6.1. And that's all you need. Now, you'll get to the custom Proton here for Steam, which most likely is going to be Proton GE. For the installation of the glorious Eggwell Proton, we'll use Proton Up QT. And that should be it on that front. If you need to get Steam, well, there are a few ways to do this. Sudo apt install steam dash that, which means this is a glob. So you can install Steam using that method. But I'm not going to be doing that here. But what I can do is also go through Lutris. So we'll do github.com/Lutris and Lutris. Yes, okay, there we go. But I head to Lutris.net here and then go into download. I guess the best way to go about Lutris is how you do game management, if you will. Open this sucker with GDebi, the GDebi package installation. And we'll do this because why not? Enter our strong and complicated password. You know the deal. Let all of this get fixed up. Let all of this stuff download and whatnot. But that said, if I'm not mistaken, that is how you do Linux Mint. Now, if you want a little more information on this, I have a Linux Mint 20.x installation guide that will be linked in the description below. I made a tutorial on how to do this properly, especially with the NVIDIA drivers. Make sure you check that out if you want more information. But that being said, I'm out of time for today's video. If you like this episode and want to see more like this in the future, you can do this one of five ways. You can hit the like button to show your support to the CodeUS Nation, hit the subscribe button to become a member of the CodeUS Nation, hit the bell icon to be notified when new episodes arrive every Thursday afternoon at 2 p.m. Pacific time. You can also comment on all of our videos. All videos are open for comment. And last but not least, you can share this channel with your family and friends. But that being said, I am out of time for today's video. Thank you, and good night.